Oh, hi there. Sorry, I didn't see you there. I'll just talk to you in a minute. I'm on level 248. This is your brain on Candy Crush. So why is this game so addicting? It starts with a simple concept. Match three shapes of the same color in a row. You get little rewards every time you get a match and with each level that you pass. There's little lights and explosions, points flashing across the screen. There's a happy little dancing character and you get put on the leaderboard after one level. All of these accomplishments are registered as mini rewards, releasing the neurotransmitter dopamine. Nicknamed the pleasure chemical, dopamine works to reinforce pleasurable behaviors. This is the same neurotransmitter involved in addictions. It keeps you coming back for that rush of dopamine. And that's not all. As the levels get harder, you need to play more in order to get those same rewards that you're used to. And since the game is based on luck, in other words, you don't know which colors will appear on your screen next, the award schedule is unpredictable. You don't know when you're going to be rewarded, so you keep going and going and going. In psychology, this is known as variable reinforcement, a concept first understood by psychologist B.F. Skinner in the 1950s. It's like a slot machine. You don't know when you're going to win, so you might as well keep playing a little longer just in case you do. This variable reinforcement will keep you playing since you don't know when the next reward will be. Another reason why this game is so fun is that it creates an illusion of control. As we keep playing, we think we're getting better and developing a strategy to earn more points, when in reality, Candy Crush is a game of luck. We're not developing a skill, we're matching random colors to earn a reward. But that illusion of control is what draws us in. I got one more reason why Candy Crush is so addicting, and that's because the game makes you wait. After finishing a few levels, you run out of lives and have to wait 30 minutes before you can play again. This can be so frustrating, you just wanted to beat that level. The saying, you want what you can't have, applies here. If you want to win those levels, you have to come back in 30 minutes, in an hour, the next morning, the next day. That is another reason why you keep coming back. Well, that's it for today's video. I hope you joined that small snippet of knowledge. If you'd like to learn more about this topic, I've linked all my sources below so you can read more about it. Thanks for watching. I'd really appreciate it if you subscribe and hit that like button under this video. I'll see you next week, and remember that science is everywhere.